everyone. I am obviously, as normal, just checking in, making sure that I'm up live, because obviously we know that my technology expertise is not great. But it's fine, we've all got our strengths and weaknesses, and technology is a weakness of mine. How is everyone? I am using my mum's phone today to do some music, so if it goes off, we'll just blame my mum. Oh, we've got a little guest. Got a little guest, Bertie. He's saying hello. Come here. Oh, good morning, everyone. Bertie has come to say, oh, hello. And he's all snuggles this morning, wasn't you, Bertie? Oh, yes, he was. Are you going to go up to bed, yeah? I'm going to give him a treat and he's going to go up to bed. Okay, my mummy shouldn't have let him down so quick. There we go. Right, put it there. So how is everyone? How's everyone doing? I'm hoping I'll be able to live on Lord of the Dance. Got to turn my phone on silent. Turn this on silent. Because I can't have this on loud. So there we go. Oh, and we're in. Okay. We are in. Good morning, Angela. Just watching Celtic Tiger. Good morning, all platforms live. Good. Carl says, good morning, Liv. I hope that you are well and good. Checking in from Nottingham. Always good to have you, Carl. Okay, so I'm going to have a little warm up whilst we get going. Guys, I have a very special treat for you all. So I know I said I was going to do Warriors this week, and we will do Warriors. But seeing as Lord of the Dance launched Celtic Tiger on YouTube on the Show Must Go On channel, I thought what better week to do than to do some Celtic Tiger. I'm going to basically show you how we can do a very similar routine that we did for Celtic Dreams, what we've been working on for the last week, and put just how little different, even just the position of your hand and things like that, can make it look a very different style. And we're going for like that old Hollywood glam style, and you all know what song we're going to do. Of course, it is Capone. This is my favourite dance out of the whole show of Celtic Tiger, and we are going to do a little dance to it. So, what I'm going to do is just show you my interpretation of it. We're going to use the same sort of moves. We're going to go for the same format, so drill all of the turns that we've been learning, all of the movements. I'm going to teach us two new movements that are going to go into the routine. And also, it's like old American Hollywood style. And obviously, it was Independence Day, 4th of July yesterday. So, to all our American fans, happy Independence Day. Let's read some of these questions. Hi, Olivia, I'm up to tune in. Yes, good morning. Thank you so much. That is from Capone, not barking. Claire says, good morning, Olivia, from an old MOS dancer from the 90s living in Ireland now. Hello, Claire. Thank you so much for tuning in. It's always good to have MOS dancers. Sarah Louise says, morning, Liv. Miss you. I hope you're well. Sending you lots of love. Lester says, oh, I'm in the room where it happens. Lester also knows that yesterday Hamilton was up live as well on Disney Plus and loved it. So he definitely watched it without. Michelle says, hi, good morning. Good morning, guys. I'm so glad everyone's tuning in. Okay, I'm going to do a little quick warm-up, obviously, as always, guys. Having my first sip of coffee on the Monday morning with all you lot. And, interesting fact, bought this in Shanghai Disney when we was in Shanghai in January, and the next day got closed. Good fact. And I was with, it was me, Cole, Joe Harrison, who you saw last night, and Nicole Kelly, and we had the best time. It was so good. On YouTube, Robert McCoy says, hi Olivia, it's 3 a.m. in Milwaukee. Oh my goodness, I can't believe you're still up. Well, hello and happy Independence Day. Woo-hoo. I know it's yesterday, but it's always good to just spread the cheer, isn't it? How's everyone been doing this week? It's been a very strange week, I feel. They're relaxing the restrictions, we've got a bit more freedom. Don't know if I like it. It's gonna get some getting used to. The Robinsons are in the house. Yes, hello, Annabelle, hello, Jasper. Hope you're well. Caroline says, morning. Katrina from the Smile and Roll Yellow Academy is still in bed, but we will get you on catch up. Yes, thank you so much. Thank you so much. We've got some locals in the room. That's what I like to see. Okay, so let's get this going. No more chit chat. Here we go. Okay, guys, I don't know if you noticed, but I tried some backlighting. This was the best I could do. And it is a lampshade. And what I've learned is that the actual shade is kind of counterproductive. But I'm getting there. See, we're all learning. We're all learning. Scott O'Neill says, hi. Philippa says, morning. Okay, so here we go. I'm just going to stretch out my neck a little bit. Have a little stretch there. Flat the palm down. If you want, have a little stretch on this side. Now, I did do a little stretch earlier when I came down to set everything up. So I'm just shaking it all about, shake it all about, shake your arms out. Did you see the Celtic Tiger show live? Actually, yes, I did. My mum for my 13th birthday took me to see Celtic Tiger in Birmingham at the Birmingham Arena, and it was amazing. I love Celtic Tiger because I think that it's really inclusive for every single style. I think it really goes well, and the way that Michael Flatley portrays the kind of old style Hollywood glam, you know, the very like musical Hollywood, I love. So that is why I'm gonna try my best to do it today. So I know I did promise Warriors, and I promise you I'll do it next week, but this week was just a little like 4th of July Celtic Tiger celebration. Okay, here we go. I'm gonna just turn this off because it's Celtic Tiger still playing on my thing. So what we are going to do is we're gonna start off with our normal balance up, down, balance up, down. Now, what I was saying about having the sort of same steps but in a different style is you will see kind of over the lesson, but it's mostly about like positions of hands, the feel of something. So when we're doing this, when we're doing the drills, I am going to obviously do the kind of foundation hands, but then when we get into the routine, I'm gonna be flattening out my palms. There's going to be a lot of kind of lengthening that way rather than kind of coming through, if that makes sense. But it will make sense in a minute. So here we go. We're going to go for the balance. This is our foundation. We're going to get into position. This is the position. Okay, five. So we're going to do five on each leg. You know the drill. Five, six, seven, eight. We go up and down. We go up and down. We go up and down. Two more. Up and down. One more. Up. Stay there and down. Okay, I'm good. I'm feeling good. That was a good balance from me. Lisa Atkins says, morning, she is upstairs. My auntie Lisa says, good morning, we are watching. Good morning, Lisa and Charlie, mwah, love yous. Trudy says, good morning from the Netherlands, wow, good morning. Carl says, you seem so full of energy this morning. I am, I'm in a very happy mood this morning. I think it's because the sun is shining. Okay, so here we go. We're gonna go on the right leg always for the balance because we like to keep our bodies aligned. So here we go, five, six, seven, eight. We go one and two, up and down. Good, up and down. Two more, up and down. One more, up and down. Good, how's everyone feeling about the balances? Now guys, it probably does feel a bit silly just kind of doing like an up and down, but I promise you, if I try and turn without doing that, whoo, them turns all over the place, and I think it's to do with like not being grounded, do you know what I mean? So that is why we do the balances always. And I do this every time before I go on stage. Not kind of that extreme, but I always, before I'm on stage, especially if I'm doing awakening, as that's like a light dance, I always do this and hold it and then up and hold it, just to make sure that my ankles and my calves and my Achilles are all strong. So yes, and I'm hopefully going to be doing like loads more dancing and videos, so I've got to make sure that these ankles are going to hold me up. So we're going to go in for the turn. You know how I feel about this. Shake it off, shake it off. Okay, let's see if today's a good turn day. What do you all think? I'm not sure. So we're going to go for one simple pirouette. Do you know what? I'm going to ask, what is the rule? Because I say it every single week. And I'll be very, very, very happy if someone's actually taking notice of me and remembers the rule. And I'll give you a clue. If you want to do one pirouette, one turn, how many do you go for? And I'm going to wait for a second, because I know that someone's going to know this. Someone's got to know this. Come on, I say it all the time. I'm going to have my sip of coffee and wait for the answers to come flooding in. Okay, no answers yet, but I think that there is a delay. So I'll repeat it. If you want to do one turn, how many do you go for? Michelle Bishop says two, no! Okay, I'm gonna repeat it one more time. If you wanna do one turn, how many turns do you go for? Two, guys! No one's listening to me! You go for none! Nil pois! On Twitch, Nicholas says, good morning, how are you, Olivia? I'm good, Nicholas. Joe Howard said half. I'll give you that, Joe, to be honest. That's the best answer I've had. Daniel says 1.5. Cheater. Close, but not. Okay, guys, I'm going to repeat this one more time. If you want to do one turn, you go for none. Because what happens is the momentum of your body will just spin you around naturally. If you want to do two, Michelle Bishop got it right. She said none. Yes, Michelle. Robert McCoy says two, I believe. No, on Twitch, Nicola. Right, you're all just copying now and saying two. If you want to do two pirouettes, you go for one, okay, guys? Because your body and your momentum will take you down, take you round. Okay, we're going to go in with a single pirouette. Here we go. A five, six, seven, eight. We go one and down. Good. Five, six, seven, eight. We go one and down. Good. Now remember what I said, guys, about the down on Twitch. Yes, Carl got it right. Michelle Bishop got it right. Guys, when you do the turns, what the most important thing is, and I think obviously technique and stuff does really help and it really runs in, but I think performance is the most important thing. So if you mess up that turn, that you finish like this, like it was the best turn you've ever done, no one's going to know any different. People are just going to be like, wow, did you see that ending? Yes. Got to be very clever. On Twitch, Apollo says, good morning, Olivia. I'm excited for the stream. Thank you, Apollo. I'm excited too. Okay, so here we go. We're going to do three more turns, three more single turns. Five, six, seven, eight. We go one and down. Not bad. I'm going to finish really dramatically now, okay? And you'll see the difference. Five, six, seven, eight. We go one and two. Now look at that. Didn't that look like the best turn ever? Guys, that is a single turn. Go for none. The momentum will take you round. Okay, guys, here we go. It's the double. I'm going to have to shake this off, I think. I'm going to have to shake it off. And I'm going to have to figure out the double turn and just, you know, shake it out. Here we go. Here we go. Here we go. Shake it off. Shake the legs off. Here we go. Double turn. Double pirouette. You got this, guys. You have got this. Here we go. A five, six, seven, eight. We go. One. Did you see that? Like, this is because we are consistent. Every week we turn up, we do the foundations, we do the holds, we do the single pirouettes, and now we are smashing out doubles, guys. I don't know about any of you, but I definitely feel like my turns are getting stronger. I feel better in myself. Next week, I might go for a triple. I'm just saying, I might attempt it. We're all friends here. Doesn't matter if I do, if I fall off it, you know. So, I'm going to go for that one again. Five, six, seven, eight. We go. One. Guys, consistency is key. Working hard pays off. Look at us. Do it, smashing out these pirouette turns. Like they're not like they're a hold now. It's like we're doing the holds. Guys, I really hope that everyone's with me on this and everyone's seeing improvements in their turns and feeling good about them. Feeling more confident, that is the key. Okay, we're gonna go in again. Five, six, seven, eight. We go. One. And down. Okay, guys, come on, you've all gotta be with me here. You've all got to be with me. Like, are we not doing really, really, really good double pirouettes now? This is a hard move as well. And when you're on stage, you want to know in yourself that you are able to deliver that move. Guys, I'm so proud of us all. Hamish says the double turn looks brilliant. Thank you, Hamish. Okay, we're going to go in again. We're going to do it two more times. And then you know what's coming. We're going to add in the kick up, down, okay? But I am adding in a different arm to the kick up, down. To do with style, to do with how to adapt the styles. Okay, but we're on the two double pirouettes now. So five, six, seven, eight. We go. One. Down. So proud of myself. Five, six, seven, eight. We go. One. Okay, guys. Well, we all know what today is. It's a good day. Oh, turn in a turn, oh, it's a good day. Oh, turn in a turn. Okay, here we go. So, we're going to go for, on Twitch, Phaseway says, yes, it's very hard. Yeah, double pirouettes are extremely hard. I mean, that's why I'm so happy that I'm doing them, because I'm like, whew. My pirouettes have definitely never been this strong. Maybe when I was at college, because I was doing them every day. But, yeah, absolutely. Chris Stiles says, great, thank you. Okay, so now we're going to go in with the double turn out and back, okay? If you're new to the channel, this is kind of what you're looking to do. So you're going to do a double pirouette. You're going to swoop up and come down like that, okay? It does look hard, but trust me, you'll be able to get it. Ask the people in the chat, everyone, we're all doing them now. But what I want to explain, what I want to explore today, and we're all going to do it together, is the way that a hand movement or just a feel can change the complete style of a move. So this is me doing it in my Celtic dream, very light, very fluffy, kind of what I think about like a fairy floating in the wind. This is me doing it that sort of style. So I've got very soft arms and I'm going turn, turn up, and then I finish round like that, okay? Very soft arms, very kind of breath and things like that. Okay, now this is me doing it, Michael Flatley, old Hollywood Capone, like I'm channeling kind of Michael Flatley in Celtic Tiger, I'm channeling Fred Astaire, Ginger Rogers, all of them greats, okay? And what I'm gonna do is when I finish, my arms are gonna go like this. So I'm gonna push out, so it's kind of like, bam, like that, okay? And there's going to be a slight bend in them, so it's going to be like, da, and I kind of push out from my chest, okay? And my head's down like this. So that's the start. This is the shape I'm going for at the end. Bam. Okay? So five. We're going to just try that move and ending with that. Five, six, seven, eight. We go. One, two, Up. Okay. The move was a bit rubbish, but we'll get over there. So, Joe says, sorry, I'm in bed. No worries, you can do this later in the day, guys. You can re-watch it. I'm always here for you. FaceWay says, wow, you're talented. I'm not very flexible. Oh, thank you. Guys, the beauty with turns and this move especially is flexibility doesn't really come into it. It's more about strength and guiding, grounding. Obviously, yeah, this is quite a flexible move, but you can do it low. You can do the double turn, hook, and have it low. So yeah, does everyone understand about the way that your arms are, bah? So we're gonna try that again. We're gonna finish off very old school Hollywood, bah, okay? 5, 6, 7, 8, we go. 1, 2, up, bah. Nice, guys, okay. How are we all feeling with that? How are we all feeling with this? Bert just heard me go back and he's gone mad. So, what we're going to do is, I might have to put Bert upstairs in a second because he's been a bit naughty this morning. So, that move, the turn, turn, up, back, is in the start of our dance. We're going to go into our dance the same as we did with the Celtic, the Stolen Kiss solo. So it's going to start off 1, 2, 3, and heel one up. But when we do the back and one to get into that double pirouette, we're going to do this with our arms down, okay? Just little things like that. You're going to put in your little styles, your little bits of style. Okay, on Twitch, Nick, Bertie, yeah. We're not giving Bertie any attention this morning because he's been a bit naughty, okay? And he loves the ball spun floor as well. He always goes and sits on it. And when I'm trying to dance and practice on it, he's always sitting on the edge. Okay, so we're going to do that turn, turn, up, back. One more time, and then we're going to go into the axle into the turns that go like this. I'm going to change the arms, okay? So here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. We go. Bah. Nice. Okay, we're going to go again. Bert doesn't really like me dancing, by the way, just to let everyone know. Here we go. 5, 6, 7, 8. We go. Turn, turn, up. Bah. Nice. And guys, I want to see the performance. I want to see the dance. You know, you're a star, darling. That's what I want to see. Everyone's saying hello to Bertie now. Guys, you're too good to him. Okay, so the next move that we're going to do is the axle. And again, I'm changing a lot of like the soft arms to big arms. So when we come round for this, for the axle turn like that, this palm is going to be facing front like that. So this palm's going to be flat, and this palm's going to be flat, and you're going to go, you're doing the same movement, but palms are flat. I think my mum's coming down to get Bert. Are you?
Yeah.
Bert's gone because he's been a naughty boy this morning. He shouldn't be down here for the streams, and I talk to him.
Come here.
I talk to him and I tell him. So, we're going to go flat palms. We're going to go flat palms, okay? So we've gone from soft palms to flat palms, okay? Here we go. So I'm going to go over the axle move that we're going to do. So you go from your left leg and you go 1, 2, 3, and flat palms down, okay? And then you're going to be like this kind of move. And if anyone can see, at the end I do this with my shoulder, very like, oh, Hollywood. So, someone said, Nicola says, practice Stolen Kiss with Bert on the pool spawn floor. Do you know what? I'll do it. Hamish said, did you build up your leg strength from dancing or from other gym work? No, I actually really did build up my leg strength from dancing. When I was younger, like I was always kind of climbing up things and climbing everywhere, so I think I've always been quite a strong person anyway. And then yeah, with Irish dancing, obviously my legs just got really, really strong. When I was competing, kind of going to the gym wasn't a thing. Like we didn't think that could help Irish dancing. that's only come around kind of recently. People have done more research into it. There's amazing people out there doing it. And now, obviously, we do know that there's benefits of training it properly. But when I was dancing, there wasn't any of that. I went to class 4 to 5 times a week. If anyone watched my read my story on Facebook, thank you so much for all the support, by the way. It actually means so much. Lots of people reached out, so I really appreciate that. But I went to dancing probably 4 to 5 times a week, mostly 5. And then I feshed on either Saturday and Sunday, so I was constantly dancing. And I was always doing sports and stuff at school, so... Dadnam's in the house, good morning. Okay, so I'm gonna do this axel again. If anyone wants a recap, your legs are just simply going bang, bang, like this, okay? So we're gonna go 5, flat palms, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, and flat palm down, okay? And you're gonna kind of like down at the end. Okay, here we go. How is everyone doing with that? Caroline McGuire says, hi, Elif. Hello. Diane says, hello from Long Island, New York. Hello. Thank you so much for tuning in. Okay, here we go. So we're going to do that one more time. Remember, flat palms. Give it a style. That's what we're looking for today. I think today's a key word. I'm going to add this in now. We're going to have a key word of the day. Today's keyword is definitely style. How can we style this out for a certain genre, a certain mood of music, okay? And that's what we've got to really think about. So, flat palms, here we go. 1, 2, 3, 4, axel, ha! Okay, good. So, what I'm gonna do now is teach you the very start of the little routine. It's only about 16 bars, it's not long. And they're the only two moves that we're going to do into it. Oh, and the turns. So, after the axel, we normally do these turns, don't we? 1, 2. Ha ha, not anymore. So, we're going to have flat palms. So we're going to go 1, 2, 3, and axel round flat palms. And you're going to bring them up like this. And then you're going to come forward like this. So you're going to bring them up. And then you're going to step and come forward like this, okay? And at that point, I imagine like pyro to go up. My name saying Olivia in big gold lights like they do in Chicago, the musical, where they sing Roxy Hart and her name comes up. So I want to see like you come up, you've got flat palms, come all the way up. And when you're coming up, you don't come up like this. You come up with your back kind of... like this, okay? Very Fosse-esque. Turn, 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 step forward, and bam! Like that, okay? And that's gonna kind of be like the ending of our little routine because I'm only doing it this week because it's a celebration of Celtic Tiger. So, got a new comment there. Hamish says, yeah, I read your story, it was very good and inspiring to me. Thank you so much, guys, I really appreciate it. Okay, back to business. So this is going to be the very, very start. It's not an Irish dancing move, okay? So this is a new move. It's just a kickball change. So you start with your right leg and you're going to go kick, ball change, bum, one, okay? And this, I'm going to come a bit closer. That leg's bent, your left leg's bent, your right leg's out, your shoulders are pushed forward, your head's tilted back, and your arm is resting on your hip and on your leg. And then you're going to drag it up, and as you do, it's going to be really slow. And just as you get to the very top, you're going to go again with the left. Kick, ball change, one, and then you're going to do the exact same position on the left leg. And you're going to come right up, right up, right up. And that arm's going to come in, and then you're going to go kick, ball, change, and then we're going to go into, and 1, 2, 3, and heel, one, up, bam, da, da, and we're going to push out, okay? So no more soft arms. Very explosive, very sharp, and a lot of kind of tilted heads because very stylistic. Joe Howard says, no, still in bed. I'm exhausted just watching you. Look, we can do this anytime. Need some of Liv's iced coffee for the extra power. It's not iced this morning. I honestly thought it was a cold day. How wrong could I have been? That is a hot coffee. Not really enjoying it as much as I normally would, to be honest. Okay, so we're going to go with that kickball change hold, okay? Now remember, we're in the 50s. It's America. We're in New York. Okay, we're going to get a cup of coffee and talk about our daughter's drugs. Please tell me that is a good accent, because if I've offended anyone, I apologise, okay? But you can all take the mick out of me, I don't mind. So, we are going to go old school New York, Hollywood. We've just come off of Broadway, okay? That's the sort of vibe I'm giving. I'm in like a kind of suit-esque outfit, okay? I basically look like the girls in Capone in Celtic Tiger, okay? I've got a hat and a cane. I haven't got a cane, but I imagine a cane would be near me. So, you're going to walk. We're going to do the same walk that Flatley does. I'm going to put my own twist on it as I'm a woman. So I'm going to cross my arms because he does this, but I'm also going to kick my bum. So it's going to be like, do, 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 do. Oh, we'll probably do the last four bars. Do, do, do. Du, 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 du. And then you go kick ball change one. Kick ball change one. Kick ball change one. And then we're going to go into the set, okay? How is everyone feeling? Liv just went to Brooklyn. Was that a good accent? I do say that all the time. I actually say it to Joe all the time. Get a cup of coffee and talk about our daughter's drugs. I need to stop doing it really. Okay, we're going to go in again. Again, it's about the feel, it's about the style. You want to build up that kind of portfolio of where you've been in life for that character, what you do for a living. I'll tell you a bit about myself. My name is Dolly. I'm a showgirl dancer on Broadway. I maybe go out with a gangster. I'm not sure. I'm in the 50s, I've probably got short dark hair. I wear a lot of like faux fur, got a lot of jewels, I'm apparently very rich. This is what I'm thinking the whole way through doing this, okay? So you're doing your walk, you're gonna go da, and we're gonna go bang on where it goes da, 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 dum. Okay, so it's gonna be very sharp, you're gonna go kick ball change one. Kick ball change one. Kick ball change one, and then you're going to go onto the dance. So the next little bit of the dance is our normal. Is our the same start as Celtic Dreams. So we're going to go. It's going to go kick ball. It's going to go kick. Kick ball change, one, two, three, and heel. We're not going to do the heel, we're just going to go one, two, three, and on that turn, you're going to go and da da da. Okay? So it's going to go and one da da da. So, very big feel. So, we're going to do that one more time and one, two, three, da 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 da. Okay? And then you're going to do the turn, one, two, kick, bam, okay? Then, we're going to do some slides. So you're here, and you're going to go, and one, up, okay? So, that move is just, with your right leg, you go, and one, and up, like this. And this is the shape that you're giving. So you're gonna go and one and up and one and up. And then you're gonna do the turn like we did in Stolen Kiss. But again, is everyone seeing the little details? Flat palms is a big thing. So you're gonna do the and one and up and one and up and turn. And they're gonna be flat palms. And this leg is gonna come up to meet you. So you're gonna go and turn. And you're gonna be like this. And then you're going to do the axle forward. And one, and axle. One, two, three, four. One, two, three. Okay? How are we all doing this? How are we all getting on with this? Olivia, you are so elegant. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you so, so much. Okay. My bird's still trying to get into the shop. Okay. So, we're going to just... I'm just going to play the very start of it and show you the... That's very loud, isn't it? And show you what I'm going to do for the start of it, okay? So, here we go. Okay guys, technical function. There is a malfunction, sorry. Here we go. So I'm gonna do the last four. One, two, three, four. Kick on the change button. Kick on the change button. Kick on the change button, two, three, and one, two, three, da, da, da. One, two. Up, and one, up, and one, turn. And axle, keep turning, bring them up. One, two, three. Yes, guys. How are we all feeling? Tell me, let me know what's going on. Oh, I found that quite hard. That is a very... Do you know what it is? The beat is very hard. The volume level is good. Okay, thank you, Jason. How was that for everyone? That's tough. It's a tough gig. If you take anything away from today's lesson, I really want you to take away like the kind of vibe and the fact that we are doing very, very similar steps, but just by changing like the tiniest movement, makes such a big difference and such a big stylistic difference. Don't even know if that's a word, to be honest. But we just made up something. And Michael Flatley is so good at doing this. Like, he did it in Capone. He did it with Celtic Tiger. He does it when the bad guy comes on and does a solo and the good guy. And immediately, yes, obviously the music's different, but immediately, even just the hand movements, like the bad guy's very do. Do, 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 and the good guys are very da, 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 you know, very open. Just little things that we as an audience member can't even think like that. But Michael Flatley, being the amazing choreographer he is, does think about things like that, and that's what makes the shows so enjoyable. Klaus says, good morning, dance queen. Olivia, have a nice day. Thank you so much. Hamish says, that's fantastic. I love the music as well. I mean, I love the music. Okay, guys, we're going to go in again. So, here we go. That's my mum's playlist. So, I'm going to actually put this music over here so that it's not too loud. Here we go. I'm changing them. Didn't like them, just sort of. So we're going to go turn up, and we're actually going to turn out and come down like this, and then step forward out like that. Oh, he's back. Okay, I'm just going to let him out and let him out. He can stay outside. Because he's being very distracting this morning. Sorry, everyone. Okay, so, Liv, you're on fire today. Thank you. Okay, so we're going to do it a couple more times. Remember, style, add your own thing. Who's your character? Let me know. My name's Dolly. Nice to meet you. Okay, here we go. So, I actually can't work my mum's phone. She's an iPhoner. I'm an Android. It's very, very different. Okay, here we go. Favourite day. Awesome, I'm feeling pumped and now up. Yeah, can't speak Hamish. Pumped up now. There we go. Good English there for me. Guys, how is everyone feeling about that? Just them tiny little things to make it different. The palms, the push out of the chest, the overall feel of it. I know that I feel very, very Hollywood doing this. Another little thing, forgot to mention, I think I just made it up on the spot to be honest. But when we do the and one up, when we do that, like I am really pushing through them arms, okay? Oh, I'm gonna kill this dog. Come on, get in. Go up now. Oh, what a naughty dog that is. Do you know what? If he was in Lord, he'd be on Team Bad Guy now. He's been really naughty. Who's saying says hi, hello, welcome. Guys, if you're new to this channel, you will know that we do Irish dancing, but we like to put a bit of a different style swag onto it. So hello, good morning. Okay, guys. No, Bertie's not back in the room, okay? We're not doing this. He's not allowed. Everything's shut now. We've got a gate is shut. So we're gonna go in again with this dance. We're gonna do it a few more times because I really feel good about this and I'm really enjoying this dance. So here we go. Walk it out, strut your stuff, kick ball chain run, feel the music, kick ball chain run, yes, and again, kick ball chain run, 2, 3, and 1, 2, better than that in terms of like enjoying the music, enjoying the style, love it. How is everyone feeling about that? And the last move, like, I mean, I'm going like this and smiling because I'm enjoying the dance, but if I was on stage, I probably would give a bit of a little look and be like, and not smile because, you know, I'm cool like that. Okay guys, how are we all feeling with that? Let me know. Let me know if you need to go over anything, because obviously I've kind of flown through that quite fast. Guys, 470 calories we've done this morning. I don't know about you, I might have to go back to bed. How is everyone feeling with that? We're gonna do that a few more times. One, because it makes us feel good on a Sunday, and two, because I wanna get this down. And then that is actually two routines we have learned. And that is, I'm really proud of that. So, here we go. Crushing it today, thank you. Okay, so here we go. We're going in again. The swag, everything needs to be there. I love it. How's everyone feeling? Gonna have to get my breath back. Carly Morris says I'm watching from North Wales. Welcome, welcome. Thank you so much. Okay, guys, I think we just need to do this a good few more times. Get the blood pumping, get it going. Remember the style, the flat palms, the kind of bent elbows. Very different to our stolen kiss routine, but equally as fulfilling. I love this routine. This is definitely more me than a stolen kiss routine would be. As much as I love being like very light and airy and you know, soft, I do love a sharp dance. And this, everything, da-da, bah, like I'm stopping. You could hit me and I would not fall on that. There's so much strength and I'm holding everything. So let's go again. We're going in. Here we go. Guys, I hope you're enjoying this as much as me. I'm loving it today. If I do say so myself, probably shouldn't. Okay, here we go. Movements. Is it harsh to switch styles on the fly? So I'm very lucky because I've got trained in both. So I don't find it that hard to switch. In my head, I kind of think of it more as a little hand movement there, where my head is. Like I said, in Celtic Dreams, we're very soft arms. The head's always up. The eyes are always, we're always very bright. Whereas when we're in Cats, it's a bit more like down and, you know, the head's down and the eyes are a bit darker and just, it's definitely sharper like we do down, up. So just definitely a different feel, and I think once you get used to that, you can start doing your own interpretations of things. I love jazz and it's probably what the best thing that I was at in terms of other styles of dance when I was at college. Yeah, I love stuff like this. Old musical theatre Hollywood style is my style. Would be interesting to see Cahill dance Capone. I can probably bet that he is amazing at it. Because, let's be honest, what is he not amazing at? So, guys, we're going to go in again. Hamish says, very good, fantastic way to kickstart my Sunday. Always here, Hamish, on a Sunday. Okay, we're going to go in again. Remember, now I want to know where you are performing. I'm performing on Broadway right now. My name is in lights. And yeah, my backdrop is just a whole curtain of just bulbs. And then it says my name in that. Not that I've thought about this, obviously. Okay, here we go. Oh, here we go. Olivia's question to the chat room is if you are performing this routine. Yes, tell me, where are you performing? I want to know. Guys, how are you all feeling about that? I'm sweating. I don't know about you. And I think the hardest bit, the bit that's making me sweat is the, and one back, because I'm putting so much effort into it. How are we all feeling about that, guys? Let me know. I'm on Broadway 950. I'll take Broadway 2021 though, Jason. Wink, wink. I'd love to do Broadway, but seriously, that's where I am, or I'm on the West End. I'm in some theatre with my name in lights behind me. So guys, I want to know where you are. A lot of calories burnt today, there certainly is. Okay guys, so we're going to do that. Dos more times, two more times, and then I will, 2021 is coming soon guys. Woohoo! So excited! Because I think I can vouch for everyone when I say thank you next 2020. Do you know what I mean? Like, go, you're out of here. We're over it. Okay guys, here we go. We're going to do this two more times. I want to see the energy. I want to feel the sharpness. I just want to have a good time. Picture exactly where you are. I can tell you exactly my costume, how I look, how I'm feeling. That's what you want. Michelle says she's in a London theatre. That is a good choice, Michelle. Here we go. Here we go. Okay, are you ready? Watching here because it's obviously a bit delayed, so I just want to see where you are at. Hayley says, I love the Feet of Flames Hyde Park stage. That's where I'd want to be. Oh, that's a good one. Well, Hamish, I might have to steal that one off you. Okay, I'm with Hamish, I'm there as well. Guys, how are we all feeling about this routine? It just shows you how we can do the same steps, we can do the same sort of choreography with just minor changes and hand placements. And that is how you change the style of a dance, how you can interpretate music to a with a different style. 5 years ago, oh yes, guys, 5 years ago yesterday, Michael Flatley did his last UK performance. Was it his last UK performance? I think it was. And he danced on Wembley, and we were in the Dominion troupe, and there was a touring troupe, and the touring troupe was doing Wembley, and the Dominion troupe, we had to finish the show, so they worked out all the logistics, that we started a bit earlier, and they started a bit later, finished the show, we had to drive from the Dominion to Wembley, a full troupe, in different taxis, in our encore costumes, making ourselves look pretty after we've just done a full show, get up on stage and do Michael's last UK performance, and he had two troops on stage, and it was honestly the most amazing feeling ever. I actually saw a video of it the other day and it brought back so many memories and I loved it. So I'm very, very lucky to have been a part of that, because it really was like a moment in time in history. So guys, we're going to do this again and then we're going to call it a day for the routine. I say this every time and I definitely always, nearly always do it again another one. Okay. Are we all ready? I think we've all agreed that we might be either in Hyde Park, but I'll do Wembley as well. I'm not fussy. Here we go. That's why you can hear the taps, it's actually the performance. On YouTube, someone says, hello, Olivia from Budapest. You look energetic again. Hope you're doing fine. Thank you. We've had a brilliant morning this morning. Guys, I'm going in again. Let's do it one more time. One more time. Okay, and then we will sign off. Let's all do it together now. Remember the things that we've worked on, remember the palms, you know, the feeling, that Hollywood feeling. We've got this. Here we go. Sorry, guys. Tiger weekend with a dedication to Capone, Celtic Tiger. Guys, if you've got like free time, check Celtic Tiger out on YouTube. It is incredible. I think Jason will help me out here, but I think it's on the channel Show Must Go On. But it's so good. I'm actually gonna watch it today on my projector. So good. Thank you guys so much, and just wanted to say a quick thank you for everyone that reached out to me and commented lovely things and stuff on my post. It really made me smile and means a lot, and I love you all so much. If there's any questions, fire away quickly. We've definitely got like 30 more seconds, so let me know. Hamish says, thanks Olivia for everything this morning. Jason's just confirmed, yep, it's on the Show Must Go On over on YouTube, Celtic Tiger. So watch it, it's brilliant. And, you know, watch it and try the dance out. I know I'll be doing that for my mum tonight. Putting on a little show. Angela says, still watching Celtic Tiger now. Yes, Angela, she is ahead of all of us. I love it. And she's watching the stream. I love her even more. Guys, I've had such a good day. Just making sure I'm not missing anyone. Adele says, lovely. Making sure I'm not missing anything. And all I can say is thank you so much for tuning in. Hopefully next week we will be doing Warriors. And fingers crossed, but I think I'm going to do it to Cahill's piano version. I know. Mic drop. So that should be super, super good. And again, that is giving us a completely different style of what we've been doing. So we're going to be using similar moves to what we've done, but we've done like a really light and soft stolen kiss. We've done a swaggy kind of American Hollywood vibe. And now we're going to go on to the dark side. The dark side. Yeah. So we're going to be doing that. And it's going to be a bit more like creepy because it's like a piano-y solo thing. And I'm super, super excited. Yay! Guys, have the best Sunday. A great start to the week, as I like to call it. I hope you all have a fantastic week. And always, always, oh, here he comes. I'm just going to let him say goodbye. Come on. Come here. Oh, he does camera shy now. Come on. Come on, say goodbye to all the fans. Oh, you've been a monster this morning. As Bertie says, everyone, follow your dreams. We hope you have a fantastic Sunday. And hopefully I'll see you next week. Mm-hmm.